know, ladies, tarjanes, we like to fancy them. That's our favorite store. So I went in there for one item. And as I was out strolling, I accidentally ended up on that Home Good aisle. Ladies, y'all know that aisle. That aisle that have the decorative pillows. The ones that say live, love, laugh. So that means you gotta buy all three. Then I sashayed over there and found one of those lamps that required 13 light bulbs, knowing good and darn well I don't know how to put it together. But I just threw it in my basket. And I don't know, it's something about you when you spend money that you don't have. You just get a certain walk about yourself. Yes! So I'm just excited, walking to the register. I'm like, yes, I got everything in my basket that I don't need. But I'm excited. So I get there to the register, and the cashier says, ma'am, that'll be $152. Because I knew in my heart of hearts, I knew deep in my soul, my diaphragm, that I didn't have $152 in my account. But I'm going to pass in that credit card since I'm going to pass it. Here you go. I will not be defeated. But I wanted that transaction to go through so bad, I just started singing a Negro spiritual praying. No, but we have applications. So I work at Target now. But it's bad though, it's bad. I feel sorry for people when they come through my line because I just see a look in their eyes of despair. And so when they be swiping their credit card, I be trying to help them out. I just start singing the spiritual. I hope it goes through. Sugar, I want cheese, I want wheat, I want everything that's gonna go straight from my lips to my hips. That's what I want to eat. You know, the unhappy eaters, they just need to survive. They don't need to drown their sorrows like the rest of us. They don't. You know, the thing to do in LA, you know, everybody, you know, the thing to do, they invite you over their house for dinner. So, you know me, since I swipe sensitivity, if you invite me to your house to eat dinner, I ain't eating the whole day. The whole day, I'm keeping this appetite. I'm just like, ooh, I'm going to lay out, so I'm gonna tear some shit up. And then, you know, everybody's making LA, so they all look like they got money. So on the way over there, I'm like, ooh, they look like they rich. So I know we're gonna have some steak and shrimp and lobster. Man, I get to their house and they got hummus and cucumbers. What in the hell is hummus? I've never heard of hummus got to love your neighbor. Love your neighbor. I don't care what race you are, what color you are, what your Christianity is, whatever it is, you get your weight, all of that. Love your neighbor. Or do like normal people. Wait till you go in the house to talk shit about it. But when you face to face, be nice to one another. That's the thing. Just be nice to your neighbor, because you just never know what to expect. Especially here in Portland with all these bridges and shit. You be on saying the wrong shit to somebody, you be like, ew! I heard somebody say we had some Latinos in the audience. Well, I'm an honorary Mexican. I swear to God, if you cut me right now, queso is gonna come out the side. Queso will come out the mud. I swear to God. But I'll tell you, like tonight, we're gonna have fun. You're gonna get inebriated. You're gonna have you a few cocktails. And right before you get home, what you gonna do? You gonna stop at Chicken Box for them two tacos for 99 cents. You gonna stop at Chicken Box. It's just, your car gonna go there. It's just going. It's going to Chicken Box. And it's nothing worse. It's nothing worse than pulling up to Chicken Box and Consuelo is working a drive-thru and she hits you with one of these. Welcome to Yakin' the Box. Would you like a yumbo yak with you? Yeah. Then I get loud with you like you deaf or some shit. Welcome to Yak in the Box. Would you like a yumbo yak with you? Bitch, does my sandwich need mine? Stack, what is you? It's not really a promise, you know. I love Hispanics. They keep their kids in the stroller. They carry their kids in the stroller to be about 12. We just be hanging off the side. Play a game tonight. This is the problem. We're gonna play a game, and it's called No Matter What You Got Going On, We're All Alike. We're just different. So I want you to repeat it after me. We're all alike. We're just different. Give you a couple of different examples. Back in the day when I was dating before I got married, when I was happy. I wonder. My dude, like I said, I got Caucasian friends. I got my Consuelo cousins, my Latinos, and I got my black friends. But one time, the dude I was dating, he got caught with another woman. So my good girlfriend, Becky with the good hair. Becky called me. She was bring. Hello, Crystal. I was like, hey. She's like, are you sitting down? I was like, do I need to be? She says, hey, you know I don't like drama. Namaste. But I just saw your boyfriend with a woman that I've never seen before. She's not in our book club. Never seen her in the carpool lane. She's not even in our Zumba class. And you know what we do in Zumba. We get down in Zumba. Okay, focus. But when he gets home, you might want to have a non-confrontational conversation with her. Because it could have been nothing. But then it could have been a lot because they were looking really, really cozy. Okay? So she said it so calmly, guys, that when he did get home, I was like, was you in a bitch at Zumba today? And he was like, no. And I was like, okay. I just looked that up. It was totally different when my good black friend Keisha called. First off, when Keisha calls me, her ringtone is totally different. When Keisha calls me, her ringtone goes a little something like this. I ain't sorry. I ain't sorry. I ain't sorry. Hell no! She called me, she was like, bitch. I was like, what? She was like, is your boyfriend home? I was like, no, he's not home. She said, I know he's not. I said, right over here at Harvey's. appetizer, entree, and pizza. I mean, she cute. No, she ain't got nothing on you. She cute, but you know, you real MVP. She cute, but she ain't got nothing on you. Wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute. They leaving. They leaving. They leaving. The license plate is 776. 298. Hurry up on the phone. Y'all got Keisha. Y'all got Keisha. Same thing, same thing. When you go to a sporting event, like I said, we're all alike. We just a wee bit different. Same thing. You go to a sporting event, Becky. Becky with the good hair. She don't sing the Star Spangled Banner. And it was meant for everybody to sing along in unison as one big happy family, right? I'm Becky with the good hair. Sing along with me. Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars. Gonna go when Keisha sings it.
Rebus.
I better stop when I put my wig on and show this. Start singing, you'll be like, that's Keisha!